what I'm going to do, and I'm going to explain to you and the audience. Chris, say hi.
Yo.
So the Josuke theory, or kind of who saved Josuke, is kind of a dead thing, conversation in the JoJo community. No one really talks about it. It's kind of a closed, shut case. No one really cares, I think, anymore. Just wanted to kind of put my hand in the pot. And also, I just wanted to get your opinion on the things that people believe is the reason, or who saved or who didn't save Josuke. So I'm going to just go through with you what people think, and then we're just going to kind of go back and forth. Cool?
Yeah, sounds good.
So, numero uno, this is one I think is most believed by the community, and it is pretty much, I called it the anybody and everybody theory. Pretty much it just means it could have been anybody. And the reason people think this is because Ariake says a lot about like the goodness of humanity, and he just likes when nice people do nice things. So people are just saying it was just a delinquent looking guy who just did a nice thing. And that is the most agreed upon one I've seen out of Reddit and everything. That's what people think it is.
Boring.
Yeah.
Put that on the boring scale right
yeah.
now, man.
Yeah.
Boring. It's a good, I'm not saying it's a bad theory. It makes sense.
Right.
But
it's boo.
The right. way how the scene was directed, the way mm-hmm. how the scene was shot, mm-hmm. I think, I would assume, and I still do assume mm-hmm. that it's more than that. If there, it can work, and it probably does, but it's boring as shit, and it, I do not like
also
it
with this
it.
Theory, there's no like evidence needed. I think that's also why it's assumed. Like, you don't really need to. Oh, it's just a nice person. You could be like, I guess, right? You know what I mean? There's no, there's no need to like point holes or, you know, pluck holes or anything about the theory. So that one is pretty much boring. I knew you weren't gonna like that one. I don't really like it. I understand it. Like, it's a nice thing. You know, it's nice. It's cute. But let's move on to the next one. We'll kind of go back to them, and I'll kind of go with it through you. Okay. I call this one the jailhouse lock theory. That's a JoJo reference.
Okay.
Jailhouse lock is that one stand that made Jolene not remember like three pieces of information. Remember that?
Oh, okay.
So this one is the worst one. They just think that Ariake forgot. He just forgot about it. It just fucking sucks. There's not really much to say. It's just not good. We really don't want this to be the truth. I don't think this is what happened. Do you think he just forgot?
It is very possible. Because there is reports of, you know, these talented writers mm-hmm. have, you know, forgotten, you know, important characters, like in Dragon Ball, you know? Some characters weren't as often in Dragon Ball Z.
Launch
was somehow just mysteriously disappeared, you know? you know, it has happened. But you're probably, I do agree with you. I don't think that's the case.
Yeah.
I don't know. I don't know how the scene played out in the manga.
It was fairly similar. I'll show you panels later, but it looks pretty similar to what happened in the anime. It's Koichi explaining why Josuke has the hair that he does, and he kind of goes through the backstory. So it's from Koichi's memory of what Josuke told him. But it shows the same pretty much scene. Pretty accurate. So that's the worst one. I don't think that's what happened. Also, I don't think that happened because Ariake hasn't showed signs of too much inconsistency throughout his story, in my opinion.
Yep.
You know, let's be honest. Toriyama, is that Dragon Ball's name? Is that the dude's name?
Yeah, Akira Toriyama, yep.
Yeah. Homeboy, you know what I mean? Kinda getting
Fumbles.
Up there.
Yeah.
It's been slipping up. You know what I mean?
I love them, but... You know,
yeah, no. Hey, we're like these. I put my fingers together. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
He's made some slip-offs.
Yeah. Yep.
All right. The third one. This one, I think, has some validity. I like this one. But it doesn't have too much going for it. But let's see. This is, I call, the change of plans theory. So while he was writing the story, he decided to change his mind, maybe midway, halfway through. And you know how Yoshikage has the Bites the Dust ability, and that sends time back 1 hour? If you find out that it's him, right? It just sends you back 1 hour with that little kid. Like, his ability maybe was even more cracked, and that the Bites the Dust was some type of fucking send you in the past type shit. And maybe, you know, maybe something happened with him and Josuke. They got in a fight. Josuke got hit with the Bites the Dust, and it sent his ass back to his fucking childhood or some shit. Maybe. I think this one's cool. Also, the reason why I like this one more so is because Josuke and Yoshikage don't really have much screen time together, right?
Yeah.
And even the final blow isn't done by Josuke. It's done by Jotaro. And with Josuke and Kira, Josuke has like a dark suit at the end of the show. It's the same suit. And then Yoshikage has a light, you know, has the white suit with the whitish hair. And they're very like opposites of each other. Josuke can heal anything. He can revert anything back to what it was. Yoshikage can destroy anything he touches, right? It's a lot of like dichotomy. So I like that. I think they should have had more screen time. And I think if they had a huge final fight where he fucking sent Josuke back in time, I think that would have been sick.
Yeah.
So what do you think?
If that was put into part four, I think that would have been worked nice. I think that would have been cool. That's what I honestly thought was going to happen when I was watching the show. But it didn't, and if it did happen, but they didn't show it, because that's what the theory is basically saying, right? It happened.
No, they're saying that he completely changed it. Like, he had that idea at the beginning of the show that he was going to send Josuke back in time, but midway through, he was like, that's too much, like, that's maybe difficult or some shit.
I think that's very plausible. I think that's more possible than him forgetting.
For sure.
I think that this is so far the best theory yet, because it makes more sense.
It's more interesting, for sure.
More interesting. It's good. I'll put it like, you know, if we're ranking, you know, that was like around like, you know, B or A tier. You know, okay. Pretty good. Pretty good. Not bad.
Okay. This one is the three pins theory. This one's kind of confusing, I guess. Kind of say so in Japan. To kind of symbolize what grade you're in high school, they'll have pins on their collar, right?
Uh-huh.
And Josuke has one pin, which is, I believe, the heart pin or something like that. And so does Koichi.
Okay.
They're freshmen. They're freshmen in high school. And that's what's symbolizing that. And the guy in the flashback has three pins. Okay, so this is post-video Spoon. I keep noticing that I say pins instead of really like lines on the pins, because if you notice here in the first picture, it has two lines, which I would assume this kid is a sophomore, and Josuke, he has multiple pins on his collar, but none of them have multiple lines like individually. Obviously his anchor is a whole bunch of lines, but you'll get what I mean by, with the savior, he has multiple lines on his individual pin. And also, when I show Koichi, you'll see that he has multiple lines when he's older. So that was my bad, but back to the video now. So that would mean he was a junior.
Interesting.
So what I am taking from this is that it's still Josuke, but also, if you notice, in part 5, you know when you see Koichi in the very beginning of part 5 with Jotaro?
Uh-huh.
Koichi has three pins. So the beginning of part 5, they are now in their third year. So it could be that Josuke was maybe a part of part 5, or maybe just during this time period, he has a run-in with a stand and he gets sent back in time.
Okay. He just runs into what type of stand? Just a random...
Fucking, it could be Diavolo. It could be, you know, Diavolo doesn't really do that, but maybe there was a time stand. Or maybe Diavolo had cracked out powers and Josuke was a part of the ride and his ass just got sent way back. Because it is his third year and that's the same time period as part 5.
Interesting.
I thought that was kind of interesting.
Huh.
What do you think about
it? I think it's nice.
There's a lot of ifs. I think there's a lot of ifs, ands, you feel me? But
if this was the case, because how I usually perceive the whole show is like after the events of a certain part, the main character of that part kind of stops fighting in a way, you know? Like, I know Jotaro and
Joseph.
Yeah, I guess Joseph. But fucking My favorite character, man. How the fuck Polnareff? Is his name? Polnareff, yeah. Yes. Because I know after part three, they go on their other mini adventure.
Right.
But how I perceive, because especially after part four, I think more of fighting Stans would be not over, but like it wouldn't be as impactful as anything crazy. I'm saying, you know, they won't have their villains anymore, right?
Right.
They'll have maybe like, you know, bullies.
Right, a couple of stands little, here and there. Types.
A couple of stands, yeah. But they won't have their villains, right? They won't have their Diablo, their DL, you know, they won't have that anymore. So, and I feel like if Josuke met someone that can literally send him back years to the past.
Pretty fucking dirty stand.
I think that's a kind of a big deal.
Yeah, that's a big deal. That's why I would say if that were to happen, it could make sense in a part five. Like if it was a part five, but it couldn't be a random stand. That would have to be a big boy.
That would be a big boy.
Yeah. So, and also the other thing is you can tell that Jotaro kind of has more of a friendship with Koichi rather than Josuke, even though they're brothers. All right. Wait, brothers? No, they're like, what are they like?
Half brothers. Yeah, they're half brothers. No.
They're like cousins.
Yeah.
I know. Right? How the fuck? I don't know. Joseph cheated, so.
They're blood related.
Yeah, they're blood related. And you could tell that Jotaro has more of a relationship with Koichi. That's also why he invited Koichi to go with him to Italy. So I just think it would have been, I guess, more nice to see Jotaro and Josuke kind of buddy up a little bit more. If he took them all also to part 5, I think that would be kind of cool. But it is what it is.
That would have been crazy to see three judges in one.
That would have been sick.
In one part. That would have been crazy.
Yeah. And then like midway through, they just send Josuke back. You know what I mean? Back in time. He just never comes back.
Yeah.
All right. So this is my theory. Well, two of them kind of work, but you know, regardless. This is kind of my theory. I don't have really much to say here. You remember part 6, the big bad stand made in heaven, right?
Yep.
Did a whole bunch of timeline stuff. Changed a lot of shit. Timeline. Whipty wopty woo. Everybody went back, kind of knew what was going to happen in their lives. Kind of went forward, right?
Yeah.
I think that it's possible that Made in Heaven could have had an effect on the timeline, and maybe that's alternate Josuke who got somehow sent back and is now living his life again or some shit or something like that. I just know that Made in Heaven has to do with timelines, and it's plausible that he could have sent another Josuke or just a Josuke, many a Josuke, know what happens in their childhood, and motherfucker, you know, whatever happened with the timeline, now he's bleeding, who knows how he saves himself because he knows what happens, it's his life.
Okay. Yeah.
I don't really got much to say about it. It's just like Made in Heaven has a whole bunch of timeline stuff, so I don't know, maybe, right? I don't know, maybe.
I mean, yeah, there's a chance. If it would work, it would be confusing to explain how it would work.
I still couldn't explain to you Diablo's powers.
don't ask me either. So.
Which one do you like the best out of the ones that I said?
That's tough. I'll put yours and the one where the writer forgets. No, not forgets.
Like changes it?
Changes it in the same tier. I think the first one is boring as shit.
True.
I think the others, I don't remember those.
What about the three pins?
Three pins. I think that one works and it makes sense. But the thing is, that kind of pisses me off. Because I would want to see it go down, right? I want to see what happens.
Yeah.
Right? How the scene was directed, it just too many details and added to it. I was like, there's no way they were just gonna scrap it and just say just some random nice dude was hoping by. No, I think that's lame because there's just too many details, right? Just too many, like, if you're gonna do that, just make the good guy, you know, just a simple good guy. I don't know, why was he bleeding? You know, why do you have, you know, the same suit, right? He had the same suit and the pins. It was just,
but that is a high school outfit though. That's just a high school.
I know, but I think just him not adding the voice, right?
Mm-hmm. Right.
Because I think, because
that was a little weird.
Everyone in that scene had a voice, right? Yeah. But the mysterious stranger didn't have a voice.
Right.
And that's what piqued my interest the most. Why? If it was just some random fucking dude that was doing
they would give him random
nice, it would have just, yeah, just give him random fucking a voice actor, right? Yeah. But no, they specifically cut out his voice and added subtitles. I think that's what piqued my interest the most.
Yeah. But also, I do want to tell you, I actually voice acted that part.
Oh, you did?
Yeah.
How much did you get paid?
Not much.
Yeah, because they cut it out.
Yeah, they cut it out, yeah.
I mean,
all right.
That sucks.
Yeah, I mean, that's pretty much it. I mean, that's all I want to say. So you like the change of plans theory. You kind of like the Made in Heaven theory. The first one's kind of lame. We don't believe that he forgot. Homie did not hit himself with a jailhouse lock. And three pins, kind of cool. That's about it, right?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. I do have my little a little theory.
Go for it.
I'm a little shy because it's fucking ridiculous. But all right. So the series is gonna have to end, right?
Of course.
No matter what, you know. And that's how everything goes, right? Sadly, but JoJo is gonna end sooner or later. Don't know when. Don't know how. But I do think that this scene alone has given me a theory that the last part, and I don't know how the last part, you know, nobody knows when is the last part. Last part is going to require all the JoJos, right? Mm. Fucking mind-blowing, right? Stupid. Mind-blowing stupid, but listen. I feel like the final villain of JoJo would have to be menacing. Disgustingly OP, right?
Of course.
So I would think somehow, somehow it will require all the JoJos to take part on taking down this villain. And this villain goes crazy, right? They all fight the villain and, you know, shit is going down or whatever, and just somehow Josuke just gets sent back in time, you know, to where an important life-changing experience happens in his life, right?
Right.
I'm assuming the villain does something, you know, yeah. And he gets sent back in time. That's why he's bleeding. That's why he's bleeding. Mm-hmm. And that's why, you know, he's there, right? And you're asking how will that work? I'm assuming obviously this villain has multiverse,
yeah,
reality,
multiverse,
whatever.
Shit. Yeah, he would have to have something like that too. Yeah,
you know, he will bring JoJo's obviously from different centuries and or decades, whatever, yeah. Generations, and that's the theory that most likely will not ever happen. Because it's pretty shit. But I do think that could
cool.
be a small theory that can potentially 2% chance of happening. And if it does happen, I do want to staple my name on it, and I do want to say that I did this, and you're welcome.
I like it. I mean, I like that a lot, personally. I think that's sick. But at the end of the day, I don't think that Ariyaki knows the ending more than three parts ahead.
Yeah.
I think he writes in threes, like three parts. Like he goes 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, you know, 7, 8, 9 type shit. I think that's how he like thinks. Feel me?
Yeah,
but
yeah.
Maybe he was like. Also, I do want to add this last part before we get ran through in the comments. There is an interview before part 4 was finished, and the interviewer asked him, "Oh, what about that thing where Josuke goes back in time?" And Ariyaki just kind of brushes it off. He goes, "Oh no, that's in the past. We won't talk about that again." It's kind of generally that's what he says.
Exactly, he's right. It is in the past. It is in the past, and he knows what he did. I think he knows what he's doing. Like I said, is either one of the last three, him changing the story midway, Made in Heaven, you know, changes a few things.
Yeah, changes.
Or my dog shit theory that has 2% of happening.
Yeah.
You know, actually happens. So.
Or two.
But we'll see. Yeah. We'll see. I mean. We'll see in, I don't know, 20 years, I guess.
Yeah,
who knows?
Motherfucker's never stopping, huh?
No, he's not stopping.
Any last, I don't know, words?
I got no words. Nothing.
Alone at the edge of the universe, humming a tune.
or merely dreaming we were snow. A siren sounds like the goddess who promises endless apologies of...